Yusuf was never still. He was adding rooms to his own house, and his wife wanted chickens.
A house is empty without a chicken in it.
They could remember when every family was self-sufficient, owning its own wheat and cows and chickens. A sheep, bought at the beginning of the year and killed before winter, would last through the next year. Now wheat and mutton came from Australia and Syria. They had not seen a cow for years, and there were only 3 goats in the village. The people lived by their apple harvest or their olives. There was a time when the coast could not be reached except by tracks, and people who had fallen sick had to be trussed on donkeys and taken over the hills to Beirut. Yusuf had said that the village must have a road, and one Sunday everybody left church with picks and shovels and started to build it, and linked Massa with the highway to Beit Ed-Din in 2.5 years. He and his wife grew poor again because of his illness, but he bought a barren hillock to the south of the village and imported vines from Italy and worked for 15 years until the soil bore fruit.
The hill is steep and difficult. Every 8 feet we had to build a terrace, but it is only the rocks which spoil the farming here.
He held up the palms of his creased hands in a gesture of fruitfulness.
The soil is rich, if only you plough it.
They did not know if they would be able to return to the United States, but the Stetson hung in the passageway, and they poured their arak from an American whiskey bottle. Everything they had gained, they had made with their own hands from striving. Their world had grown up from strength year after year, like the cedars above them. As I climbed into the mountains, Drew's women came onto their rooftops in the village below, clasping their long veils in their hands as they pointed me the path, and by this graceful semaphore I reached the road to the cedars. Clouds moved along the rim of the mountain, as if the wind chafed the snow there. Far ahead I glimpsed a copse, strangely compact and solitary.